Give a person a fish and he will eat a day. Teach him how to fish and he will never go hungry. Lao or someone important like that said this. As the title suggests, in this video, I'm talking about the media I consumed to learn French. I moved to France 5 years ago and have learned it to fluency since then. I've given a TED talk on my language learning experience and I currently work at LTI. And I think I was chosen because they could place me at their client site, L'Oréal, and L'Oréal's management speaks French. I'll start this video with the proverbial fish part, the media that I like so much, and then I'll talk to you guys about how you could go out fishing yourself. I love watching YouTube, so I ate up all the free, good quality French content out there. I wanted to sound like a native, so I started watching TV show channels like TV 5 Monde, Canal Plus, and so on. When I would watch this, I would realize that I don't follow squat, and I realized I should start with something a little easier. And believe it or not, my first easy TV show that I watched was Dora the Explorer in French, Dora l'Exploratrice. For me, it's not about the entertainment with this one. She definitely does not entertain me. But it's about learning the new words and the new expressions that she comes up with, the sentence constructions and so on. I even use these references to this day. I make jokes with the little things that she said because I know the French people around me today have watched this when they were young. I then discovered my favorite TV show for kids, the French one called Petit aux Chabrins. I watched so much of this. I even know the song by heart because I've seen it so many times. This one is way cuter than Dora the Explorer. It's a little brown bear and he's just, it's like he's vlogging, you know, but someone else is vlogging him, talking about his day, little 5 minute videos. They're talking about what he did today and he dirtied his clothes and he has to take a shower and all that kind of stuff. French vlogs for beginners. I also downloaded these two videos on MP3 format on my phone so that I could listen to it when I'm in the train, and I would just go back and listen to it again, go back and listen to it again. And currently I'm doing the same thing with Dutch. Shifting gears onto level two, then there was music. Now, no more stuff for kids, a little more advanced. A friend of mine told me about this artist called Section Dasso. There are some good songs. They have turned out to be controversial after that. Now this music is much faster. It's rap and it's not like regular French music or classic French music. But I have a magic formula to tackle that. I call it the golden rule. In fact, I've made a whole video about it. Check it out over here if you haven't already. It is possible to pick up rap as well. You can't expect a beginner to learn 13 songs overnight, but you can definitely pick a song in a whole month if you just listen to it over and over again. I also listened to Tal and La Fouine on loop. They were there in the mix somewhere and I listened to a lot of them because that's all the French music I exposed myself to. It was not about learning everything about the French culture, but doing one or two songs, but doing them right. The only free French TV I knew about back then when I was in India was this thing called Extra. It is this language learning thing by Discovery Channel, and now they even have one in German. Now when I watch back the German, I realize how difficult it was in French. It's difficult if you're a dead beginner, so go back to level one, and if you're in level two and you're struggling, that's fine. Stay with one episode. Note down what they're saying that you don't understand. There are subtitles. Make a list of the things that you don't know and try to use them in sentences. Actually, let's just stick to the media on this video and I won't talk to you anything about the methods. On va s'enchaîner du coup. When it comes to movies, I've already spoken about this before. I've watched this movie called Intouchable. I've seen it over and over again. If you haven't watched it, you can buy it on YouTube for a small price and it's yours for life. It's a good movie to download. There are these phrases from this movie that end up sticking in my head. Après tout, pourquoi pas? Tu prends tes clics et tes claques et tu fous le pont ici. Stuff like that. I can almost predict when people start a certain thing and thanks to this movie. This movie is good. Switching gears to level 3, the ultimate level. As you say in French, les films cultes. A simple Google search will give you a list of 100 movies that you can watch, but actually keep it simple. Pick up 2 or 3 movies that are in this list that are really relevant. Almost any French person would have seen these. So for me in this list, I've watched Les Bronzés font du ski, Bienvenue chez les Ch'tis, Le Dîner des Cons. I didn't love all of those movies. Bienvenue chez les Ch'tis, I really liked a lot. And there was a part 2 as well that came out. This movie I really loved, but Le Dîner des Cons, I didn't really think it was funny. Les Goûts des Autres, I didn't like that movie either. I just watched it for the expressions and the French stuff, but I really didn't like them either. Oh yes, check out this movie called Persepolis. This one is based on an award-winning graphic novel. It's really well written. It's about this existential crisis that this girl has. It is so well written and it has so much French, of course. to stay on the free side, there's also bref. This is a gift to humanity, at least the part of humanity that's learning French. I have a list of these expressions on my phone. Where is my phone? I have a list of these expressions on my phone. It's really a long, long list that I've made. Half of this list is from bref, I'm sure. Every time I hear something that I don't know, I pause it, I look it up on Google, and I put it down on my list. Bref is amazing. It's everyday language. And if you meet someone in France, chances are 9 out of 10 of those people have seen bref. I keep saying everything is my favorite. I don't think one thing needs to be your favorite, but actually let's stop rambling and get back to the video. I've also seen other TV shows by Canal Plus written by these guys. There's Bloqué, Serge Lhomito. For Bloqué, watch these two episodes. I really like them a lot. Si J'étais Riche and Les Jeux de Mots. They're really well written. Have a look at those. If you like those, I'm sure you like the other guys as well. One part of the media that I've consumed, I've kept it intentionally for the end with a disclaimer because they're on Netflix. If you don't have a Netflix account and you're a student, don't go out and buy a Netflix subscription. Buying the Netflix subscription won't make you fluent, so that's a disclaimer I wanted to put out. But if you have Netflix or if you're willing to share it with someone and it's affordable, then these TV shows or movies will be interesting for you. All-time favorite. I think everything is my favorite, really. But 10%, if one half of the expression list was from bref, the other half of those expressions should be from 10%. I love this TV show. I think I've seen it twice over, but it is so realistic, so everyday, so authentic. I love this TV show. 10% is the place to go. There's also Family Business from the guy from Serge Lhomito, Jonathan Cohn, and he's really informal. I do enjoy this guy's humor. He has a poker face sometimes. There are two seasons of this. I'm sure you'll enjoy Family Business too. If you don't know Audrey Fleurot, she was a secretary from Intouchable. She's also in this TV show called La Bazar de la Charité. Oh, by the way, from 10%, another benefit is the actors keep their real names. So you get more accustomed to the French culture because you know these guys and you know their work. Audrey Fleurot, for example, the next TV show I'm suggesting, Le Bazar de la Charité, has been in 10% and also in Intouchable. And if you have to discover her work, one of her best works ever, it should be Bazar de la Charité. It's a little ancient French, it's not everyday French, so the expressions may not be as relevant today. But if you're in an intermediate advanced level, this TV show is... Omar Sy from Intouchable also did Lupin, two seasons again, Netflix. Enjoyed this TV show, I binged it over 2 weekends. When it came out, I loved this TV show. Really well written. Even if you're not learning French, I think you can watch this TV show. I've also seen a few episodes of this TV show called H. It's a really old TV show. Sometimes it can be a little... those jokes may not fly today. But the actors on this TV show turned out to be really popular later on. There's Ramsey, there's Debouz from Jamel Comedy Club. These guys are really iconic comedians today in the French culture and they came from this TV show H. Even Eric, he's in another movie that I saw last week. Mohamed Dubois. Also on Netflix, watch that movie too. It's not on my list, but watch that movie too. And he was from this TV show, H. If you're a beginner, don't focus too much on the quantity. You don't have to watch all the movies and have all the expressions in your head. Just focus on picking one or two and then doing that really well. You'll be surprised how much you can learn from one movie and how much of this stuff can be applied to everyday French. Now about the fishing thing, the second part of the video. It's going to be short, this one. It's not going to be 8 long minutes. This part is going to be shorter. I consume these things because I enjoy these things. If it wasn't this, I probably would be watching English American TV shows. But if watching TV shows, watching movies and listening to music is not your thing, ask yourself what it is that you do in your first language, what it is that you do in English. If you read books or if you read, I don't know, scientific journals, imagine that you're born in France and look for French alternatives. If you like to read about Feynman's lecture and now you're French, not Indian or an English speaking dude, then what French stuff could you consume in this? There's this nice vulgarization by this YouTuber. He's E for the electron thing, but also it's a jeu de mots for e-pensé. This guy has 2 volumes of books. If physics is something that interests you, if reading comics is your thing, there's Asterix and Obelix, there's Tintin, there's Le Petit Prince. Proverbial fishing thing would be make a list of how you like to spend your time in your first language or in English and find alternatives for those activities in French. And if there's something specific that you want to ask me, hit me up in the comments or on Instagram. This video that you're watching currently fits in perfectly into the magic element which I left undescribed in this video right over here, where I spoke about learning the first 1,000 words or learning French as a beginner. Talks more about the method that I followed. It might be interesting for you as well. But otherwise, that's been it for me. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'll see you in the next one. And until then, keep learning.